Hi, I'm Suryansh Vashne, BSc second year BZ group. So let's begin with our GRE that is on the topic elaters and bryophytes. So elaters are basically ribbon and tube-like elongated structures which attach to the wall of the spore, and they help in the plant spore dispersal by coiling and uncoiling in response to the change in humidity. So elaters are to increase dispersal because they push the spore out of the plant by absorbing moisture. So how elaters function? Elaters are basically hygroscopic in nature, therefore they allow them to absorb the moisture. Okay, this nature, as a result of which they absorb the water and swells up, and this swelling up just exerts a pressure on the wall of the capsule and they just comes out of it. Okay, so when we talk about the elaters are present in moist or the dry conditions, so elaters when are present in the dry conditions, the same procedure has been continued, like they absorb the moisture from the environment and just swells up, exerts pressure, and bursting will take place and the spores come out. But when we talk about the conditions are dry, the spores no longer stick to each other, and in this the elaters just uncoil to extend out from the spore and will catch the currents, and therefore the spores are just dispersed. So when we see the images, you will get that. So elaters in bryophytes or in different bryophytes. In liverworts, the elaters are cells that developed in the sporozoite along the spore. They are complete cells which consist of the helical thickenings at maturity that responds to moisture content, but except Funaria, Rickettsia, and Sphagnum and other species. So in hornworts, the pseudoelaters are present, which are branch clusters of the cells that develop in the sporozoite along the spores. They are complete cells, usually without helical thickenings. No helical thickening is present in the elaters of the hornworts, but helical thickenings are present in the liverwort elaters. But in mosses, the elaters are absent at all. So when we see the first image, it is about peristome in Rickettsia species. I will tell in the next slide. Horsetail, a spore and elater of a pteridophyte, a pseudoelater of hornwort species, liverwort species elater, Marchantia, open spore capsule, and the other elaters. So, when we talk about Rickettsia sphagnum, they do not consist of elaters at all, but consist of a special structure which is called the peristome. It consists of a ring-like structure which having the triangular teeth, and they are usually 16 teeth in a single peristome which separate from each other and able to bolt both in to cover the stoma as well as back to the opening the stoma and help in the spore dispersion. Okay, so this is all about the elaters and the bryophytes. So I will make you more clear that in liverworts the helical thickenings are absent, and in are present, and in hornworts the thickenings are absent, and in mosses do not consist of any elaters at all. Thank you.